We met at Brands. I worked in the front, he worked in the back.
We were working at the bike shop.
He was there before me and he built the bikes and I kind of sold them, so we were like a little team.
And she would never give me the time of day. I liked her for a while. I'd always try to hang out with her and she would always blow me off.
I went to prom with him, and I don't know if you would call that our first date.
We never actually made anything official when we first started seeing each other, so.
We had a really good time together. He liked me at that point, and I just wanted to be friends. It really wasn't orchestrated or planned, so to say. We just kind of were bored and said, let's hang out. So he picked me up, and we drove around on the North Shore in his big, giant lifted Jeep.
We would drive around, go look at nice houses on the North Shore. He'd always be on school nights, too, so we'd probably stay up a little later than we should have. And we'd always go to this one block up by my school, and we would always look at this one house and say how we always wanted to have something like that one day. And I always wanted to kiss her, and I was too shy to.
There really wasn't a first kiss. Well, of course there was, but I remember our first non-kiss because we, it was just like a perfect moment sitting in front of this big, amazing house, and we were like so close, like his head was like right here, and like we both wanted to do it, but nobody had the guts to do it.
So I remember on the drive home from that, we actually mentioned it, like, oh, that was like the moment right there. We both knew it was, and we never did anything about it. So I think the next day we went back and we did the same thing. I remember back one Valentine's Day, I actually gave her a present and left it on her doorstep. We were supposed to hang out earlier, and I had like a whole plan for it, but I had a card in the shape of a heart, and after she blew me off, I think I cut it in half, and I left it on her doorstep at her house. And I remember her calling me later that day, but yeah.
Our first fight, we weren't technically dating yet, but our first fight's what kind of made us start dating.
After she wouldn't give me the time of day, I kind of tried to move on. So I started dating this other girl, and that evening I actually happened to get a tattoo right on my arm.
He was kind of mad at me because I wouldn't, like, I didn't know if I wanted to be with him or if I didn't, so it was kind of like on and off, and he was hating me for it because he said I was leading him on and he was kind of sick of it. Wow, I sound like a jerk.
Probably about 2-3 in the morning, I'm at my house sleeping, Jess calls me, and she says she's outside.
I went out with a couple of friends that night, and just talking to them, I realized I really wanted to be with him. So one of my friends drove me to his house, like 1-2 o'clock in the morning. And he came outside, and his arm was all covered in plastic because he just got his huge tattoo.
I'm like wearing my tank top, this is all like wrapped up and sore. And she's saying how this girl I'm seeing now isn't good and she's gonna screw me over.
And I started screaming at him about how I wanna be with you, what are you doing, this is stupid.
And I was just at that point so frustrated with her because she never gave me the time of day, so I'm like, what's the story now, you know? Like, what's going on here?
And he's like, you're the one who doesn't wanna be with me, yada yada yada.
She ended up hitting my tattoo, like slapping it.
And I slapped his tattoo. He screamed. He was so mad at me.
And it hurt so bad, and she's crying, and she's drunk. And I see the car that they drove her in, they're parked over there, and it was all their idea to come and tell me this, because apparently she was talking about it all night.
But long story short, that's how we came to be, because I yelled at him and slapped him, and then he yelled at me, and long story short, that was it.
I don't really think there was anything that made me feel like she was the one, you know, in particular. I feel like it's just one of those things that I just knew it, I just felt it in my heart.
I don't think there was a moment, like a specific moment. For me, it's just kind of been a lot of moments put together.
I remember before, you know, we would ever really hang out or anything and I'd see her at work, I would always talk to Bobby at night. And I would always say, you know, like, she's the girl. Like, I can see myself marrying this girl.
Every day, I'm just kind of reassured that he's the man I want to spend my life with.
Just one of those feelings. I just knew. I just knew Jessica was one.
Three words to describe Chris would be hardworking, determined, and a country boy at heart.
Three words that best describe Jess. First and foremost, bubbly. Very outgoing person, she always has a good time. Second word to describe Jess, she's pretty. I love her, I think she's beautiful. And third, caring, very caring. She's always willing to help you out, help others out. Always taking care of me when I'm sick. She's a good girl.
We were coming up to our 6-year anniversary, so I kind of wanted to know what he thought and where he stood on the whole our relationship thing. So I tried to have a conversation with him, and every time I do, he just shuts me down. He's like, "Why? Well, we don't. Well, doesn't matter. I like what we're doing. Don't you like what we're doing? I like our situation." And I'm like, "Really? It's been 6 years. We should do something about it."
We actually had the ring already from her grandma with the stone. Kind of held on to it for a week, kind of just thinking about this is the right time to do. I didn't make any moves, so I went back about a week later, ordered the new setting, had them put it in. Then I had the ring in my possession for like a week and a half, 2 weeks, while I was kind of thinking what the right time is.
About a week before, he was acting kind of funny, like he wouldn't let me see his phone. Not that like I ever looked at it, but like he wouldn't let me pick it up and hand it to him. He was texting, and he was like kind of like texting away from me, and I'm like, "What are you doing?" And he's like, "Nothing." So I was like, "All right." I didn't really think anything of it.
She had no idea it was coming. I didn't really want to give it away too much, so I was trying to be real secretive about it. I was kind of mean to her about it because she kept on saying, like, joking around, saying, "Oh, you're gonna propose to me?" So I'd always yell at her, "No, no, why would you do that? I want to buy a house. I don't have money for this." So I would always push her off. And
we went to the city that weekend to just get away, him and I. And when we came home, he's like, "I had so much fun last weekend. Let's do it again."
Every day at work, I was thinking, like, how am I going to do this? What am I going to do? I was looking at places to go because I didn't really want to be anywhere around here. I wanted to have, like, a nice weekend and enjoy it. So I found the Hyatt Place in Riverhead. So we went out there for a Saturday night to spend the night out there.
We pull up, and he gets out of the car. It was raining, so we didn't want to park the car yet. And I didn't think anything of it. And he parks the car, he gets out, and he takes his bag, and I didn't even realize it.
I sneak my bag out of the car, I tell her to wait in the car while I go check in, and I'm gone for a good 10-15 minutes at this point. I'm wondering, she had to think something was up at that point. I go up to the room, I put the rose petals out, I put candles out. I come back down to the car, and I'm like, "Oh, I had to go check out the room first," try to play it off like nothing was going on.
So we walk in the room, and he has the whole place decorated. It was so cute. He had rose petals all over the floor. They were all over the bed, everywhere they were all over. And he had little candles all over the floor lit.
And we open the door, and she sees the rose petals, sees the candles, and she just thinks it's like a romantic weekend. She goes, "Oh, you're so cute." She doesn't think anything of it.
Believe it or not, when I walked in the door, I still didn't get it. I was like, "Wow, you just wanted to be like romantic and cute."
I kind of go into the room with her. I start saying how, you know, we've been together 6 years now. She's like my best friend. And it's just the time's right for this. You get down on one knee, do the whole "you marry me," this, that. And that was a wrap on that. She started crying right away and said, "Oh my God, this is it."
I didn't get it until he started giving his speech, and he was like, "You know, we've been dating for 6 years, you're my best friend." And then he got down on one knee and took out the box. And I was like, "Oh my God, you're really doing this? I hate you." Like, I said that because he made me think that this isn't what he wanted. So that was it.
Everyone at work and all her friends kept on saying, "Oh, he's taking you out. It's going to happen. This is it." And she just didn't believe them at all. So it was a good thing she didn't listen to him, because it would have kind of screwed me over a little bit. I would have wasted all that money on the hotel.
So after the proposal, we went and got dinner and came back to the room and just kind of hung out, just ourselves. And then it's like early, and he was tired and wanted to go to bed. And I'm like, "All right, I'm wide awake." I was up till like 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. I went downstairs because I couldn't sleep. I went to get a bottle of water, and they were so nice downstairs. The people at the front desk, they gave me free water. They gave me sleepy time tea, which still didn't help because I went all the way back upstairs and sat and watched TV by myself while he snoozed and snored really loud. So
as much as she's not gonna want to hear it, to me it was like one thing, you know, done. It's over, sealed the deal. Nah, I got on the phone, you know, I called people. Everyone in the family already pretty much knew this was gonna be it. Our close friends already knew. So she was pretty much the only one out of the loop, her and her mom. So we did the phone call. She's crying and sobbing, this and that, and I'm just like, huh? That's good. Cut, it's over now. I slept fine that night. Apparently she didn't sleep. So I guess it's a different feeling for each of us. She's gonna kill me. Reese's peanut butter cup.
I knew you were gonna say that.
Because it's, first of all, it's my favorite.
Okay.
And now, reason why, I'd have to say it's peanut butter, so it's nutty, but it's smooth. Because I'm smooth.
Oh.
Hey, you like that?
Okay, you ready? A payday, because you love money and you're nuts. Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna reset.
Skunky.
Ding, ding, ding.
Yay!
Skunky!
It's not because he always stinks.
Bob the Builder?
Wow. You know
Bob the Builder?
I should have made Bob you
Builder's
Bob the Builder.
Bob Builder's a good
Builder.
One, right?
I should have made you Bob the
so
Builder.
So what'd you make me?
The Roadrunner.
What? Why the Roadrunner?
Because we're always running around.
I don't have tall, lanky legs. I'm not a bird. I'm not running from a coyote.
Your name isn't Bob, and you're not really a builder. My Jeep. My iPad. And the third one I kind of guessed, but my TV shows. Okay.
It's good ones, right?
Okay.
You can go with that, right?
Okay. Okay.
Probably the movies. She always wants to watch movies, and I can't stand sitting in bed watching movies. What did you pick? Come on, let's go. Your voice?
It's because you say I talk too much. So, you always tell me to shh. You want me to be quiet.
So you'd be mute?
Yes.
That wouldn't be fun.
Oh, jeez. The first time I farted. Was it home?
Ding, ding, ding! In your house.
I like when we go for walks together, when we bike ride together in certain places. And I also like just hanging out, doing nothing, just the two of us. I like that a lot, too.
I like doing yard work with you. She doesn't like that too much. And I don't like sitting around doing nothing. But yeah, bike riding's fun. Going on walks is fun. Just spending time doing stuff outside.
I like outside stuff. I don't like yard work.
One thing I love about Jess is that she's fun to hang out with.
What I love about Chris is that he keeps me sane. And I love how he makes me feel.
Keep you sane, you drive me insane.
He makes me happy. I think the things that'll make our marriage a success is our honesty and the way we communicate with each other. And we just tell it like it is.
What I think is make our marriage a success is that we're like best friends. So, you know, we get along all the time. We bicker, but it's all fun.
You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Now some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, a friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.